600 miles off the coast of Ecuador, straddling the equator, you'll find the Galapagos Islands, a volcanic archipelago of 21 islands that's considered to be one of the world's foremost destinations for wildlife viewing. Recognized by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site in 1986, 97% of the Galapagos Islands have been declared national park, and 51,000 square miles of the surrounding ocean are a marine reserve, second only in size to Australia's Great Barrier Reef. Although private vessels and tour boats were once the only way to discover the Galapagos, land-based tourism is becoming a more popular way to explore the islands, to interact with the local community, and to take advantage of the world-class outdoor activities. Exotic wildlife, crystal clear water, and a spectacular landscape. This week on Facing Waves, we're paddling the Galapagos. Ready to get their feet wet in the Galapagos, the team make their way to Kicker Rock, recognized as one of the best places to snorkel in the region.
We are arriving to Kicker Rock, locally known as Leon Dormido, Sleeping Lion Rock. Getting ready to jump in and see if we can look some sharks, especially hammerheads. Sometimes black-tipped sharks too. Eagle rays could be. And we're super lucky, why not a whale shark? Or a manta. Big fish in this rock.
Kicker Rock was awesome. I mean, we get there and you're in the middle of the ocean, you feel like, and you're going between these two ginormous rock formations, and it's, the tides are, at one point I felt like I was going downhill because there was so much movement, but it was calm in the same way, so it was kind of interesting. But below you, you had to get deep, but at one time I saw a silhouette of a hammerhead shark, and that's something I've never seen snorkeling, so that was great.
You can see sea lions swimming around you, swimming with you, doing twirls and spins while you're in the water. They come right by you. And it was absolutely incredible seeing sharks. Like, I've gone shark diving before, but seeing them just out there by the rocks, you know, right next to really tropical color fishes, passing right by you, just hanging out, not even really interested in you. And you're just able to just see them in their natural habitat was pretty amazing.
Snorkeling in the Galapagos was awesome. Max and I have been diving all over the world, and so we have always very low expectations when it comes to snorkeling, because really you don't usually see much. But here it was amazing. I mean, we snorkeled with sea lions, there was penguins hanging out on the rocks, and there was turtles everywhere, and you could really enjoy the marine life without having to dive, which is, I think, one of the only places in the world where you can do that.
We also got to swim under some of the tunnels and play around. Very playful place.
We saw sharks. It was really cool.
And turtles.
And fishes.
So many colorful fishes is great. Oh my gosh.
When we first arrived into Floriana, one of our first activities of that day was to hike up to the highlands area, and that was to check out the fresh water source.
We walked up to where the pure water source is, which is just a spring, and we saw where the pirates hung out in those days. It's only 140 people who live there, so it was really exciting to be setting foot on Floriana, because not many people have that opportunity. It was great.
Of course, there's tortoises all around, so that was cool to see, and different paths that you could take. It was our first interaction with the tortoises, and we ended up seeing them quite a few times along the way, but the first time is always the most memorable.
Once we got up to the top, we had a very, very good panorama view of the whole island. We could see a volcano crater, and just pretty much see 360 degrees all the way around the island, which is really cool. And Oksana and I just took some time to take it in and really enjoy the view. On Floriana, we actually got to go out during sunset, catch a few waves and catch a beautiful, beautiful sunset that we saw from there. It's really, really spectacular.
I have to admit, I was a little bit nervous because I'm not super good at paddle sports, but the SUP sessions in the Galapagos were amazing. The water is pretty calm, and being able to be standing on a paddleboard and yet to see the marine life, like sea lions and marine iguanas even swimming, and turtles and fish and sharks in the water, was just incredible.
I do have experience canoeing and kayaking, but I had never supped before. It took me a minute. Once I stood up, I was a little shaky at the knees, but then I realized it's just standing and paddling. A trick I learned for those who might be in my shoes in the future is once you stand up, get your paddle in the water pretty quickly. It's like a tripod. It adds that extra bit of balance when you have your paddle in the water. It's a great experience.
SUP is definitely the sport that I'm most passionate about. When I first heard about this trip, you know, I'd always wanted to visit and check out Galapagos, but when I heard this trip was to combine SUP and Galapagos, I had to definitely sign up for this trip.
So we went paddleboarding along the cliffs and the mangroves in Santa Cruz this morning, and it was a gorgeous morning. We saw a bunch of different sea turtles, and we actually paddled next to a marine iguana swimming around, which was really neat to see.
And we had some encounters with the beach master, the sea lions, and I mean, it was cool because they would just come up and play with us. We're on these paddle boards, and they would come every time we take a stroke with our paddles, they would come up and play with us and get curious.
And then we had a chance to paddleboard through these rock formations as well, and it was just absolutely beautiful. Kayaking on Isabela was a bit of a different experience, certainly different from stand and paddleboarding. We got a chance to get a bit closer to the wildlife.
The kayak tour lasted around 2 hours, and we got to see some penguins, we got to see some marine iguanas again, some sea lions going in and out of the water, and Pablo really took his time to explain the unique ecosystem that lived within that area and how it coexists with humans obviously going in and out as well.
Here, the blue-footed boobies can go up to 25 meters high sometimes, and they will try to find the shine of the scale, the fish scale, shining down there, and they will cross the water surface right above underwater lava rocks, lava reefs. And they are able to control that diving and will get a fish.
Galakiwi was incredible from the very beginning. I mean, when we got there, we met Tim and Crystal, and from right first experience, like right after we met him, we knew that we were being taken care of.
They paid so much attention to all the small details. So whether it be, you know, the usual things where they meet you up at the airport and they make sure to have your luggage and everything already ready for you, but also all the small little details, like while you're on a trail, while you're on a hike, or while you're on a paddle, they would always remind you, look over there. And they were so good at seeing and identifying and spotting all the different wildlife. But then also, even when we were in the city, they were able to point out the rich and cultural history of the places that we would visit, or the food that we were eating.
Pablo, he was fantastic. He is such a great guide. He's so passionate about what he does, and you can just hear it in his stories, and everything that he does is, it just, it makes everything super interesting. And he always has little interesting tidbits and little things to add to your experience. It makes it a much richer experience than you'd otherwise have.
He is probably one of the best storytellers that we've had as a guide. My wife and I have had as a guide in all of our travels. He's very enthusiastic. He has a lot of interesting stories.
I feel that the island was moving. I closed the book, opened it again, kept reading, and it moved again.
And the way he just describes wildlife, the Galapagos, you can really see that he has a passion for what he does.
Pepo was awesome. Pepo was so chill and so like accommodating, and then he took us all over the first island. The knowledge that he brought to the table was incredible, and we learned a lot from having him be with us and show us around.
You want to be in the shade where you can see better, easier, and look for the turtle, the shark, the fishy, and so on.
This trip has been, in communication from Pepo to Pablo to everyone, has been a real folding in of the land-based and the marine components of it, so that we're getting, I think, a much more complete picture than I ever imagined of the islands.
I have not seen such beautiful beaches, such amazing water, and definitely not such active animal life anywhere in the entire world. And being able to snorkel with sea lions and sup over sea turtles and see blue-footed boobies and watch marine iguanas swimming and just on and on and on. The Galapagos is an incredible place, and I hope more people come here and experience it firsthand so that they can understand the importance of conservation.